This is ORT.
ORT. This show is sponsored by Sunrise Organic Seamoss. Who say you can't drink sunshine?
The herbs is the healing of the nation, brothers and sisters. Hey, this is your brother, twin brothers from the Royal Maroon Herbs, 48 Right Lane, Peckham. For your healing, brothers and sisters out there, we have a comprehensive list of herbs. You can find your sarsaparilla, you can find your sea moss, you can find your brother rock, you can find your moringa. So what's up, leaf, guinea and weed? So come to the Royal Maroon Herb Shop, 48 Right Lane, Peckham. The herbs is the healing of the nation, brothers and sisters.
Today's the day I give thanks, I am here.
This is Solomon from Black Child Promotions, one of the UK's best black book distributors. And we operate across London. Come check us out. You can also check us out on Instagram at Black Child Promotions and Facebook Black Child Space Promotion. Peace, family.
ORT, we do it because we love you.
Five Ukrainians? So you calculate how much we are get at one time.
Okay.
Yeah.
You are partaking of that opportunity. I'm pleased to hear that.
First in the line, I think, is how you could summarize my position. First in the line. Come on, man.
I'm very impressed with your entrepreneurship.
Well, this is what the Tory government wants from us, you know? Every disaster can be monetized.
It's an opportunity. Yeah, it's exactly. An economic opportunity. Exactly. There you go.
Exactly. So all of the black people who are too precious. No, I'm the man in my house. Me, I make money from my place. Me, I leave arrange my building. Don't it help us?
That's like
that's what I like to hear. A mattress in every corner. That's the way to go.
Man, this topic, listen, help me to get a grasp of where you're coming from on this topic.
It was a bit vague. Sorry, fellow panelists. It was triggered by the passing of two members of the Mighty Diamonds.
Okay.
And it just got me thinking the coverage of that. And I didn't know at the time.
Okay, yeah, go ahead. Yes, repeat the where you're coming from on this.
Yeah, it was triggered by the passing of two of the Mighty Diamonds. And at the time, I didn't realise that they were the longest serving reggae band that still had the original lineup intact.
Okay.
And that's some achievement. I mean, going back about 40 years.
Yeah.
And it just made me realize this is not just a working relationship. This is a friendship, judging by the impact that the passing has had. And it just, there are a couple of other things as well that got me thinking about this.
Okay.
Before Brother S comes on, another one was, it's all sort of within the same period of time, within a few days of that, and then I saw a documentary about Motown, and it was Berry Gordy and Smokey Robinson, and even though they were talking about Motown, what came across was the friendship between these two that goes back about 60 years.
Yeah.
And Smokey Robinson was kind of one of the founding fathers of Motown and was a key player in it, but it was the friendship that came through, and all the kind of guises that Motown went through and eventually got bought up, that friendship survives to this day.
Yeah.
And that came across very strongly.
Yeah.
And the other thing was, because there was a third thing, I was watching something on YouTube, and it was an interview with Denzel Washington's son, John, who's now, has gone into films as well. He was in Black Klansman and a couple of other things. And he was talking about growing up, and he was asked about having Denzel as a father, and sort of living in that Hollywood kind of bubble, environment. Yeah. And he talked about the fact that when he was growing up, you know, he talked about the friendship between his dad and Morgan Freeman, and that Morgan Freeman was pretty much in and out of their house as they were growing up, and Morgan Freeman is his godfather. And he was talking about that friendship and the fact that this goes back to way before these two men were even famous. It's a decades-long friendship, but the two men are not very public about it. It's very much, you know, they get on with it quietly and it's not known. Certainly news to me. Yeah. So, and I just thought, well, you know, again, you know, there's something here, an untapped thing here that we don't really give much attention or credit to. The only time we think about male relationships is when they're either stabbing each other or when somebody's got a beef with each other, you know. We don't see, this side never gets much airtime, and it got my attention. And I thought it would be quite a nice thing to talk about.
And is that in regards that it is happening and we are not speaking about it? Or
I think, yeah, I'm just wondering,
it's rare.
No, I don't think it is rare. I should say, it's interesting that all of the people I've just mentioned are of a certain age. So I don't know if there's a generational element to this. Mm-hmm. But we're quite easy talking about female friendships, and that gets highlighted in all, you know, many different kinds of ways. But I don't think we talk about male friendship as much as we talk about male kind of aggression and conflict with each other. And I think there are friendships out there that stand the test of time, but men are just more quiet about those friendships, so there might be a tendency to think they don't exist, but I think they do. And it's just nice to shine a light on that a bit, really.
Yeah, I mean, as you speak about that, you know, I just think generically there's an issue with black masculinity anyway. Brother Hess, I don't know if you can hear me. We're adding Kindred live now on ORT as we speak.
I'm back. It does not look like these.
Hello.
Oh, yeah.
God of his mercy.
Brother S. Hey.
Watch out.
It's about time, Brother S.
Watch out. Watch out.
Hey, listen.
You see, when you have teeth, Wi-Fi, if you do it like, oh, they did tell you something, they did learn lessons. This is one of the problems we have, you know, as a community. When somebody stop them tour and then pass on lesson, if you take it on.
So what happened, brother?
Yes, because now you end with the dodgy Wi-Fi.
So, listen, I've been listening to you for at least the last 10 minutes. I heard all about the Mighty Diamonds and everything.
Oh!
But you all couldn't hear me.
No, couldn't hear.
Look at that now. Oh.
And that means I tell you, your teeth, the Wi-Fi in the wrong way. Listen, after we'll talk. Just glad you're here, man.
Good to hear you, brother. I'm
glad to hear all of you too, you know, because I made a concerted effort to get home after coming from the gym. And, you know, I'm sitting here sweating and sweating like a whore in the church.
Oh, dear.
Well, welcome. And we're glad we can't smell you.
Can't top that one, brother. Can't top that one.
I'm sweating like a pig on pavement to a fuller house. My legs inside him a squelch.
The image is priceless.
TMI, too much information. Imagery, Lord.
Oh, yeah. I got waterfall everything. Mercy.
Let us go no further.
I feel like I need a shower,
but
it's
I'm
not
so
me.
I'm so glad. I'm so glad to hear from you all tonight. I'm sorry I had to share that with you. I'm so glad to hear that you're all in fine settle. And
you too.
I'm glad to be part of the panel. Good evening, listeners. Good evening, brother Kush. Good evening, Sister Ebony and Sister Kendrick.
Good evening, brother.
Good evening
so
to
good
you.
To hear from you.
Can I query, brother S, whether or not you are also partaking of the Romanian for the Ukrainian cash incentive?
Oh,
I don't know why I'm money.
They don't want our money.
I don't know why.
I mean, I'm not picking them.
I get my check. Per head. Per head. I'm coming back with a bungle. With a bungle.
I well believe you. Oh, yes. Well believe you.
Yes, man. So we were just trying to define the question for tonight's discussion. So Kindred has described it, but we don't necessarily have a question.
I think my question would be, yeah, is this a generational thing? Because it goes back to my point that the Indic friendship
is what, positive or helpful, or how you describe those friendships there?
I think they're positive and long. They've stood the test of time. I'm sure these men have had their arguments, their creative differences, whatever. Yeah. But the friendship has stood the test of time. And when you consider how trivial some of the things are that people fall out over nowadays, or even be prepared to, you know, to hurt or kill each other over, I just think this is significant. But I'm just wondering if it's generational, and I think there are more like this within a certain age category. I don't know if you would find this quality of friendship amongst a younger generation, but I could be wrong, and I would very much sort of welcome your views on this, whether you are seeing it, experiencing it, you know, what your take on it is. And it was that, really. And, when you think of how long these people have known each other, they've managed to sustain these relationships through thick and thin. There is something to be learned from this. And I think that it is, you touched on the issue of masculinity. And I think maybe it's worth looking at it within that context, because we kind of take it for granted that women, you know, we form connections and, you know, they can be long-standing, but we don't think about it in the same way in relation to men, and especially not black men. Yeah. And I think these are really positive examples.
So, yes, so we have our topic then. So we're looking at black male relationships, the less spoken about aspects of it.
That's a good way of putting it, yeah.
Yes. So, anything catch on a high since the last time we spoke to them?
Kevin Sammy. What was he, a relationship type? I can't really call him a counselor. And,
amused and exposed faulty logic.
Okay. That's a really good way of putting it. I guess there were some things about using the subject matter that he wrote that I thought was interesting. However, what put me off him and didn't make me, I didn't really feel drawn to him was there was kind of this underlying sadistic way in which he spoke to our sisters in this kind of, I don't know, trashy way.
Yep.
There was something about the way his disposition when he spoke to women, it was belittling, it was humiliating, it was ridiculing. And I wondered what was the point, because I couldn't see it the few times I've watched him, some excerpts that were said to me, I'm thinking, I hope he's going to tidy that up before the end of call. But now he seems to kind of bathe in it. Mm. And so I was never kind of really drawn to him.
I agree with you. I have the same thought.
Yeah,
Brother S, absolutely.
And he acknowledged that him have a very polarizing style, you know. He acknowledged that, you know. But you know something? The fact that you can talk about him and the listeners will know him, that says something about us, you know, in this world. Why we are always drawn to things that we, on some levels, in the cold light of day, we're not going to think is a really good thing that we should associate ourselves with. So then,
didn't he have over a million subscribers?
Yeah,
big following. Yeah,
and
he was controversial, and that controversy phase. But I didn't never really understand what he stood for. I know he was a fashion kind of thing, through that.
He was the angry voice of the black males who have felt neglected, not appreciated for what masculinity brings, like hard work, you know, the dirty jobs and all the rest of it.
But the thing is,
that's what I heard as his voice.
But he took away from that. His presentation didn't leave much room for kind of empathy or understanding, just his whole delivery. You know, I think if he put that to one side and really delivered the message, or the insight, he'd be more impactful in a positive way, which was more beneficial to men, I would think.
I agree. Well, not only that, because what I was saying is the issue isn't what Kevin did or how he did it, you know. The issue is how the internet works, how social media works.
It's
asking for something very exaggerated to take place, to catch your attention.
Absolutely, 100%. But then it comes down to the choice of the individual or groups, whether they buy into it.
Of course.
You know, we don't have to go to those depths to get our discussions and
thoughts. No, I hear that. We don't debate it. I'm just saying all the system works. I mean, I tell the individual because, like I said, I don't have to debate him right now because we have another topic. But I'm just saying, as crude as his delivery,
the loudest voices on.
You understand? And we are a reflection of that. You understand what I'm saying? We are a reflection of that because there are probably, as much as we can say, oh, we don't like his delivery, there's probably some people on some levels who are operating on some frequency where that is the best they can do right now. That is the best. So maybe they are the people who clicked and watched. I don't know. But it's not, you know, even you can pick any topic. Once a topic is being thought about in a respectful manner, it doesn't get as much hits as something that's going in the opposite direction. So I'm just saying he's not necessarily the problem. It's the way the system works. This oil generates fuels, but we can talk about that another time.
And may he, you know, I just want to say, may he rest in peace. I don't want to lose sight of the fact that whatever he represented or what his message was, I still mourn his passing, and I want that acknowledged. You know.
Acknowledge.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Heart attack as well. So yeah.
Definitely. Yeah.
And so young.
Significant. Yeah. 50s. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, man. And you know, I'm sure it's germinated discussions. Yes. So anything else is caught anyone else's eye?
You know, nothing springs. I'm sure there's things, but nothing that is fitting with me.
What do you have?
Can we come back to me?
Yeah, you can come back to me. All right, then. I have something. I like that one to do. Slick. You know? Don't have to dodge bullets. Right. It was this thing with Biden who say he wants to try to get $33 billion more for the war in Ukraine. I mean, I say, and at the same time, we have people who seriously look upon us and say we can't get reparations. All right, we know, say, this is not just cash given to them. We know, say, they have to go buy American goods and buy American arms. And so America go and get back something. But what I'm saying is, even the suggestion of such a figure, $33 billion, yeah, go for, and it's not like you don't send a bag of money already. I'm like, yo, man.
It's amazing how there's always money for war, isn't there? There's a bottomless pit of money when it comes to war and conflict, isn't it?
Yeah.
Man. There's no comeback. There's no,
sadly, but truly, we find that to be the case.
Yeah,
$33 billion.
You understand? American.
Where you had that? Where did you have it?
Underneath the floorboard.
That's got to be the question. When these countries, you know, the UK is the same. They're pulling money out in order to support Ukraine as well. And they're saying, but hang on a minute. Light bill, gas bill, listen, water,
listen, America is built on personal enterprise. This is what they tell us, you know. So, how is it them can't just sit back and say, these Ukrainians, they can't figure it out, you know, by themselves, you know. Because that is what, this is what we tell all these poor black people. So, listen, don't come tell us about your circumstances.
Yeah.
You understand? Rise above it.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen to some motivational speakers, read a few books, and turn things around. So, how is it the Ukrainians, I get socialist intervention now? They might ask the taxpayers. Yeah, that's a socialist, without getting too political, that's a socialist way of lifting people up, is spending money upon them. So how is it them doing that within them being supposed to be a country of pulling yourself up by your own bootstraps, if you could ever do that?
Yeah.
So it just smiles up hypocrisy, you know, and it just go under the table, and people think when somebody says we want reparations, like, you're some loonies. You've been on the walkie-bucky, beating your drums, haven't you, Kush? Hey, you've been out in the bush.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, so that caught my eye. Nothing? If not, we can progress on to the quiz. If you haven't, you don't need to manufacture anything. This is a genuine interaction amongst black people, I have, you know, listeners. You don't have to have something to say. Sometimes you can't have nothing to say. As the CMs never go wrong, as far as we can see. And with this thing, the other thing that did catch my eye was Lewis Hamilton, man. That you really tries, you know, man. You know, he's really got his pulse on and trying to communicate that, you know, some of the struggles and the obstacles that still exist, you know. I really have to big him up, especially since this thing when he wants to come in to be a bidder in Chelsea. And I just thought even having his name called up was a good thing.
Interesting.
Yes.
Somebody's lit a flame in that young man, haven't they?
Yeah, man. He's, you know. And going back to what you were saying earlier, maybe, you know, it'd be interesting to, like, some of his relationships that he has over, you know, his success came, you know. So before we do that, we have our quiz. And I know I'm with some of the sharpest minds when it comes down to matters related to melanated people. People, are you ready?
Are you ready?
So, question one.
Blue.
Yes, man.
Oh, Lord.
Yes. Positivity. So I was speaking to a friend of mine. This is question one, who has a Jamaican restaurant, and he says, I asked him, what is his most popular dish that he sells? What do you think is the answer?
Jerk chicken.
That's actually a tough one.
Yep, exactamente. Jerk chicken. And it's not even to black people.
Yeah, now that piece, yeah.
So I thought that was interesting. Okay, question two. What is the age group of black or African, if you're
Afrocentric?
Can't say the word. And don't start look over your shoulder. The age group of the black or African women who are most disrespected at work. So we're looking for the age band here. So the choices are 18 to 25, 25 to 40, or 45 and over. 18 to 25, 25 to
40,
45 and over.
That's a good question.
It is, isn't it?
Then we are trying to
figure
out. Because it's all three. We have no bad question. Look here, man. You see this brotherly thing? Don't test me.
No, I think you're right, Kindred. It's all three, for real. I mean,
When I reframe the question, no, that's me like that little segue. That's a little segue. I like it still. But Tappy.
All right, we have to choose one.
Right.
How old do you have to get as a black woman before you're respected?
You know? Oh, dear.
Yeah, I'm going to put in all kind of miseries.
Go on.
It's 45 and over. A recent article released on The Voice newspaper.
Yeah.
The survey by Henley Business School of part of the Reading University found that almost 74% of women age 45 and over from black and I think minority backgrounds do not feel safe speaking up at work in comparison to 39% for young ethnic males aged 18 to 45.
That's an interesting comparative.
Hmm.
Gender and age difference. That's interesting.
Yeah. Who knows, eh? Yes. But
that is interesting.
But I think what you say is the point you make about it is a real thing to think about when you say really. Which age? And it's so subjective. You know? Because...
Yeah, I'm sure women in all three groups could give you enough anecdotal stories about being disrespected at work.
And maybe it's the collective licks by the time you reach for...
You're
bitter like Cersei. You know, you're not telling anybody.
They've been fucking it up for 30 years.
You better tell all the bus driver, anybody, you make them know, say, what? You know them treating you in that place now. You really want to know?
Anybody who will listen.
I'll funeral them go to that man. Which leads on very nicely to the next question. So, Europeans call them ghosts. What names are most popular in the West Indies to describe the same thing?
Duppy.
Look at that. That is the fastest
answer. That's the quietest, isn't it? Yeah. Duppy.
Like I see him one on the seat.
Well, the funny thing is, it's only four of us, but I heard about six Duppy.
Well.
Yes,
we have company.
Six Duppy and two behind. Yes. ORT.
Yes, sir.
There are no deaths.
In Antigua, we call them Jumbi.
Jumbi.
Oh, yes. Jumbi, too, yes.
Yeah, we call them Jumbi.
Jumbi.
Mm-hmm. I try not to call them personally.
They say Jumbi, they ain't get you. Jumbi.
Best leave them all alone.
No peace.
If they never exist, you'd have to invent.
Leave them.
It's question four. Why has Marcus Garvey, Martin Luther King Jr., and the idea of them being honored hit the news lately?
I don't know what news you're watching.
Well, you know, just something that just casually caught my eye. Shall I put you out to mistress?
Not yet.
You see?
All right.
That's
Ebony Mike.
Ebony Mike. You know, a few of us give up too easily. That's all.
Exactly.
Let me know. Because this one is a tough one. It's a toughie.
It's a toughie.
And listen, if you take issue with the question, the research department, they're saying, listen, they're not too defensive. It was a tough one. But don't blame them.
Please ask the question again.
Right. Why has Marcus Garvey, Martin Luther King Jr., and the idea of them being honored hit the news lately? The idea of them being honored together. Maybe, no, but not together, like them together, but at the same time.
It's, yeah.
Yeah?
I can't even hazard a guess now. Because it's very broad.
Listen, when you throw up the white flag, it's never easy, all right? And it's fine. This is a tough one. So, New Ben Jack Committee Trust, NJCT, will be put to work in the United States to celebrate the lives of both of these men. This is the first time that the NJCT will be traveling abroad to unveil a plaque. See, it wasn't easy.
Far from. We really had to be reading.
But not beyond the intellect of the ORT. Fumbly. Right. Question five. So question five. I was born on the 18th of November 1952 in Lewisham, London. Having spent time in Eltham, South East London, I left to live in America and began acting at age 24. And here are a list of some of the films that I've been in. Gone in 60 Seconds. Get Shorty.
Delroy Lindo.
Yeah. Good old Jamaican Delroy Lindo.
Come on. Give it to me.
The Cider House Rules. The Five Bloods. Clockers. Brooklyn.
Come on.
It is none other than Delroy Lindo. What a man, he's so underrated, man.
Well done.
We don't hear nobody talk about him much.
Yeah, he's been over there for years, hasn't he?
Yeah, man. Don't try and pull them ones on this panel, you know. We are well versed.
Yeah, man. As long as they're not filling the clock.
Yeah.
Imagine.
Hey.
As long as you know, Anna, hey. Those who went before with a plaque. Yeah. Then we good.
But you thought you'd have a stump with Delroy Lindo, and I'm just saying.
No. Listen, man.
Quick fire.
Man, listen, man. They're coming like them, we call them them Western, then when man used to shoot, and them gun barely come out of the old stump. It's almost cheating. It's, let's call it what? It's that quick.
Yeah.
It's cheating, you know. This is where people get tested, you know. We start to test people, you know, toxicology tests, all these kind of tests. Just what is going on? How are you so fast? Yes, man. So, listen, following on from our discussion about child Q, and this is the final question. If you were school age, which KRS-One song would you sing every time a teacher walk past?
If you're school age.
Yeah, so you're at school now.
Yeah.
And you know this child cue thing and it causes a certain anxiety or whatever in us. So now that they know, if you want to be a little bit unruly, and when a teacher pass, which KRS song would you sing?
Maybe not that.
Wind them up. Like them a robot.
Oh, I was thinking about Sound of the Police. That's one of them, isn't
it?
Me too.
She was looking at me answers like, That's the sound of the police.
Yeah.
Oh my God! You run that down to some scare and I kill some teacher with that. Chant you, don't worry yourself. You gotta tease the backside out of them, man. Yeah. Don't worry yourself. Whoop, whoop. That's the sound of the. It's coming in the look. Every time them pass, give them that.
This is ORT.
ORT is a Glover Media production.